I realized in a very personal way how important the courts are in protecting people's rights. I was 21 years old in 1978. A bunch of friends and I went down to Chicago from Madison to a Talking Heads concert. We were walking down the street, and every single car had a ticket on it. And one of my friends grabbed one of the tickets, and he kind of twirled around, and then he put the ticket back on the car. A police officer came over and arrested him. I walked into the police station by myself.
I thought I was going to go in and he would be released.
Without committing any crime or even being under arrest, I was strip searched by the Chicago police. The whole thing was shocking and scary. It was very clear to me that this was a violation of my constitutional rights, a violation of my civil rights, and I wasn't going to be quiet about it. I think it was a combination of the values and the priorities that I learned as a kid. My dad was a doctor with the Navy SEALs during the war. My mom was always involved in trying to make our community better. I called my parents and I told them that I was going to pursue this lawsuit. And I just think it's really important when we've been wronged that we step up. So I became Jane Doe number one in the lawsuit that forced the Chicago police to change their rules. It was bigger than just my search.
Police officer.
Chicago area.
Accused of illegal
strip searching.
Jane Doe.
There were so many women that were impacted by this. This lawsuit spurred changes in Illinois, in Wisconsin, and subsequently all across the country. It also taught me about the importance of being able to look to the courts for those values, fairness, justice, equality.
Being a judge carries a lot of responsibility. Most important about the job is you have the opportunity to make a difference in your community.
I did a lot of things in addition to my practice of law and being a mom, and that included being on the boards of United Way, on Legal Services of Wisconsin.
She's a member of the Equal Justice Coalition of Wisconsin.
Judge Neubauer has done work for Next Generation Now.
She's been a mentor for Big Brothers and Big Sisters.
Reading tutor in the Racine Public Elementary.
I always wanted to make sure that I was giving back to my community, really in the footsteps of my mother, making a difference where I could with people who needed help.
The people who serve us well in the criminal justice system are judges like Justice Neubauer, who think about each case as a separate set of human beings.
You have to be open-minded, fair, and nonpartisan.
Based on her body of work, Lisa Neubauer has earned the trust of local law enforcement leaders.
I have seen hundreds of cases of victims of domestic abuse, victims of sexual abuse, so many cases involving the opioid crisis in our state. And we need our courts to be there to protect the rights of our people and to protect the safety and the security of our people.
And so that's why it's so important to put people on the Supreme Court who we feel can truly be trusted.
She is that voice for that fair and balanced court.
Love for family, love for community, love for country. She brings all those attributes to the bench, which makes her a phenomenal candidate for justice.
We need our people to know that our courts are there for them to receive justice. That's why I am running for the Wisconsin Supreme Court.